appreciate what you have. How can people appreciate you from outside? It doesn't happen. That's right. So we don't have to have the MC begging you all the time. You can do better. You can do better. The reason why most performers from outside Africa don't come to Africa is because they don't get encouraged. I can tell you that. Because I trained in the BBC and I know what I'm talking about. Well, having said that, most of those who spoke earlier seem to paint a very bleak future for all of us because they did not mention that in the past we had done very well. I'm going to tell you a lot of things that you don't know or that you don't wish to remember. First of all, what I'm going to tell you now is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing like the truth. Did you hear what I said? If you believe me, you'll believe anything. Look, President Rawlings and I are brothers. Do you know that? Who told you? Actually, we are twin brothers. I decided to look like our mother. He decided to look like our father. We were born in the same year. But you see, when I came out, our father said, "This one is chocolate. Can you make the other one lighter?" And the doctor said, "Yes, but it will cost you more money and it will take us 3 months. Our father said, "No problems, I will pay." So he paid the doctor. So when I came out, Jerry remained inside our mother's tummy for another 3 months. This is why I was born in March and he was born in June. Both of us are 71 now, just like Pat Thomas, he's 71. So you see, I am not happy that I can't find my brother Jerry here. But he knows I am here, and I'll see him before I go. So having said that, to start on existing protocols, let me say, Mr. Chairman, sir, I greet you. All right. There was a lady who came from Kenya. I enjoyed listening to her. She did not mention that the last American president was a Kenyan, right? Don't you know that Obama is a Kenyan? Okay, well, clap for yourself, for God's sake. That's right. So it doesn't look as if we have achieved nothing. Listen, I am going to talk about the glory that was Ghana, that is Ghana, that will continue to be Ghana. This continent has produced Dr. Kwame Nkrumah. This continent produced Dr. Nnamdi Azikiwe. This continent produced the man from Kenya, Jomo Kenyatta. This country produced Nelson Mandela. Look, Africa has made its contribution to the entire world, and I can tell you that. Before then, there were influences that were seeping through into Nigeria all the way from Ghana. If you want to assess a people and their contribution to the world, you think about their culture. Culture is eclectic. Culture is dynamic. And because of the impact of culture on the minds of people, Ghana registered an indelible impression on the minds of the entire African people on the continent. First of all, let's talk about Ghanaian music. There was a guy called E.T. Mensah. He began it all. He gave us Day by Day, and then Africa, the home of freedom. Ghana, the land of freedom. Then after E.T. Mensah, we have the Black Beats of Ghana, led by King Bruce. We had the Broadway Dance Band with Joss Akins. We had the Ramblers Dance Band with Jerry Hansen. We had the African Brothers with Ampadu. Then, of course, came the Guitar Band series, CK Man, EK Nyame, because there were so many of them. And all this music originated from Ghana. Why? In Nigeria, the genre, the popular genre in music is high life. Where did high life come from? Ghana, this is where it originated. And this is why, whenever you play high life, you cannot forget to mention that this is the home of high life. Sitting down here and looking at the young men and women performing, I tell you the truth, I've been carried away. I wish I were as light as Pat Thomas, I would have been dancing here, you know? Okay, we have said that. Behind us is a world champion. You know, Ghana became independent in 1957. Until then, so many countries on the continent of Africa were not independent. There was a football competition that was organized in 1957 between Ghana and Nigeria. It was called the Jalko Cup competition. I don't ever recall that experience with nostalgia, but with plenty of melancholia. Why? Because Ghana beat us by 7-0. You don't even know that. These people are very young men. This is history. You don't know that. You beat us by 7-0. Let me tell you, each time I remember it, I said I won't come to Ghana. But my friend here, Dr. Mattis, will always insist I come to Ghana. So I am here in Ghana. But you see, since then, you haven't been beating us like that, too, let me tell you. We have been beating you, and you've been beating us. Now, when we come to the field of sports, the first Ghanaian boxer to become a British Empire featherweight champion was somebody called Roy Ankrag. You don't know that. On the continent of Africa, I want you to listen properly. Roy Ankrag from here became the first British Empire featherweight champion. But we got the world champion before you, then you started producing them. We got the first world featherweight boxing champion, Hogan King Bassey, Nigeria. First world middleweight boxing champion, Dean Tiger from Nigeria. Then we paused. Then you took over. You got Aikwote, you got Azuma Zoom Zoom Nelson, and then the young man behind us. For God's sake, clap for yourselves. It will be difficult for you to see any country on the continent of Africa that has impressed the world like Africa, like Ghana. When you beat us by 7-0, I remember some of the names that inflicted that humiliation on us. I remember Agrifin, center forward, Wilberforce Mfum, goal, center half Charles Gayamfi, captain, outside right Babayara, outside left Salisu, left full back Oblite, right full back Odameti. Clap for me, for God, this is history. Now you know why I love this country a great deal. And you know, the way this country treats me when I come in, honestly, I don't feel like going back. You see the kind of reception I got when I came in here. It happens every time. The laptop was there. I came by road because I was afraid of flying. I kept taking photographs every inch on the way. Now, Doc prayed for me and said, Chief, stop being afraid of flying. Use a plane. And I came with a plane. In other words, I am not afraid of flying anymore because he prayed for me. And you too prayed for me. And my brother Pat Thomas helped me. And he prayed for me too. So I want to see this opportunity to let you people know that there was a time if you set from any part of this continent and you went outside the country and you introduced yourself, they will ask you, what part of Ghana is that? Do you know that? But I should know that. If you went outside the country, they will ask you, what part of Ghana have you come from? It is to tell you how popular Ghana was. Because then, if you saw a map of Ghana, you will see on that map of Ghana, Kwame Nkrumah, Osagyefo, and at that time, Onenejan was the director of sports. I thank all of you for this little opportunity to go back to history and to let you know that as Africa, we have contributed to the development of the outside world and our own continent. And I know that in due course, Africa will make more progress with what I am seeing here, because no other place qualifies to host this kind of occasion than Ghana. And to conclude, when Nasser was the president of Egypt and Nkrumah was the president of Ghana, it was a question of black uniting with the white up there in the north, and the wife of Nkrumah was the daughter of Nasser.